Hey everyone, it's Carissa Wiley at SprinkledWithGlitter.com. Thanks for joining me today. Today I am sharing a couple of holiday cards featuring some spotlight stamping and some brand new products from the Essentials by Ellen line available exclusively at EllenHudson.com. It is time for their winter 2021 release, and that means holiday products, and I am here for it. And I'm going to be using this Fa La La stamp set. This is designed by my friend Heather Meeson. I absolutely love this background stamp. And I'm going to show you how to do a little spotlight stamping with this stamp. And I'm also going to create a second card project for you. So a couple of very classic Christmas card designs that you could really create very, very many of with very few supplies. So I'm starting out by mounting this background stamp on the lid of my Misti, and I'm picking out the Fa La La that I want to actually highlight. And so I am masking all around that one and just leaving that one kind of open so that I can ink it. And this is going to be the one that I stamp in red ink. And the remainder of the background stamp, I am going to stamp in black ink. So now that I have the surrounding area masked off, I'm going to take the Cranberry Fizz ink from Catherine Pooler, and I'm going to ink up this one single area of the stamp. So just one word of all of this fa la 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 la. And by the way, you're going to fa la 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 love this stamp when you see it in action. So once I've inked that up, I am going to remove the masking and then stamp it onto the cardstock that's in my Misti stamping tool. And this is antique ivory cardstock from Hero Arts. Now I am going to clean my stamp really well. I could have actually done the next portion with the leftover ink that was already on my stamp, but I didn't think of that. So I got ahead of myself and I cleaned up my stamp really well with my stamp chamois and some stamp cleaner. And now I'm grabbing the Gina K Masking Magic. This is some fabulous masking paper if you're looking for some masking paper for your craft room. And I am going to place that onto my Misti. And I am going to ink up that same fa la la, la la, la la, that I stamped onto my cardstock earlier in the red ink. Now, if I get a little ink on the area surrounding that one single fa la la, it really doesn't matter because I'm going to be fussy cutting this out. Now, I used the VersaFine Nocturne pigment ink for this, and I wanted to make sure that I wasn't going to smudge it since the Gina K Masking Magic does kind of have a slick surface. So I heat set it, and then I am using my scissors to fussy cut this out. And really, it looks intimidating, but because there is extra room between each of the words on this background stamp, you don't have to cut it like super close to the line. So just get kind of somewhere close in the vicinity and you are good to go. And it doesn't have to be perfect because, as I mentioned, the other stamped images are not coming directly up against this fa la la word. So now that I have that backing peeled off of the masking paper, I placed it over the red stamped area, and then I inked up my stamp using the VersaFine Nocturne pigment ink and stamped it onto my cardstock. And you can see the stamp actually picked up my masking paper for me, so thanks, dude, for your help. And I have this one single word in red and the rest in black. Now look at that stamped out, especially on this ivory cardstock. It is absolutely stunning. I love how graphic it is. And this is very, to me, very Ali Edwards. And I am a big fan of Ali Edwards and her handwriting and stuff. She is the one that does Day in a Life and the Christmas one. What is it? December Daily. She was kind of the inventor of that. So if you don't know who Ali Edwards is. Now, I wanted to create a second card, so I'm taking the same stamp and I'm inking up the entire thing using the VersaFine Nocturne pigment ink. Now, this is a pigment ink, so pigment inks work for embossing, and that's exactly what I'm going to do on this piece here. I am going to pour clear embossing powder all over this black pigment ink, and then I'm going to tap off the excess, and I am going to heat set this. And this is going to give me a very beautiful black, shiny, raised image. This just looks like perfection. I absolutely love the way that this turned out. I mean, stamped on the black cardstock or on the ivory cardstock with the black ink, as beautiful as it is, because it's so striking and so graphic, and I love those handwritten fonts. But when you add that layer of clear embossing powder over the top, I mean, it is just like, mwah. I mean, so good. Now I'm going back to the first piece with the spotlight stamping that I created earlier. So it has that one little area that's highlighted in a different color. And I'm going to die cut this using one of the Essentials by Ellen Essential Rectangle Dies. Love these dies because they are perfectly sized to work with an A2 size card. And they cut not only the rectangle, but a very thin frame. So this is the 10th rectangle. So I've numbered mine from like 1 to 14 or 15. I can't remember how many there are. So 1 is the smallest one, and it works its way up. So this is number 10. And I have die cut that. And you can see I kind of positioned the red fa-la-la in the lower right-hand corner of this paper. And then I die cut this tiny little red heart from some basil peppermint cardstock, and I'm gonna place that right near that fa-la-la. I think this was like a perfect little extra touch that just really made this card super adorable. And I'm just putting it there for now. I will actually adhere it later. Now I grabbed this set. This is actually from last year's holiday release from the Essentials by Ellen line. It is called Love and Light, and I am just going to heat emboss one of the sentiments from this stamp set onto a strip of cardstock. And at this point, I wasn't sure if I wanted to do red or black. I ended up going with the black. So I prepped the surface of both of my cardstocks with some powder tool really generously. I inked up my stamp with some Versamark ink and then stamped it onto the top portion of my cardstock. I added some white embossing powder and then I heat set that. Now I'm gonna take this over to my Tim Holtz or Tonic trimmer here, and I'm gonna trim this down. And I learned this trick from Jennifer McGuire because that's where we learn all the good stuff, right? And I am going to position a piece of cardstock lined up with the edge of my trimmer. And I slid my black cardstock under that white cardstock so I could see exactly where it was going to trim. And that helped me line up to cut down this very fine sentiment strip. And that says peace and joy to you, by the way. So I went ahead and adhered my heart onto this little panel using a little bit of foam adhesive. And now I'm trimming down this strip into a banner shape. So to do that, I cut a slit up the center of the strip and cut from each corner to that center slit. And it gives me a little banner shape on this sentiment strip. Very easy to do, and it just kind of gives your sentiment strips a nice finishing touch. So I added that sentiment strip onto the little card panel that I've created using a little bit of foam adhesive, and I'm going to put this onto a craft card base. Now, I created this craft card base using the Ranger Craft Colored Heavy Stock. This made a great card base, and I am stamping this Mondo Holly. This is also from the Essentials by Ellen line onto this craft card base using some Versamark ink. So I'm gonna get this tone on tone watermark effect. It's gonna be absolutely beautiful. I'm stamping it first onto the lower right hand corner, and I decided I want two. So I flipped this around and I'm gonna stamp it on the opposing corner using the same Versamark ink. So I'm just stamping this down. I'm not going to do any embossing. I'm just going to let it be a tone-on-tone watermark effect, kind of blending into the background, giving this card base a little bit of texture. Now, I adhered this panel onto the card base at a little bit of an angle because I thought it would be kind of fun and whimsical and kind of play off the whimsy of this background stamp. And I also die cut the number 10 rectangle from the Essential Rectangle die set from some black cardstock. And I grabbed the little frame that it die cuts, and I'm putting that right around the popped up panel that I placed on my card base. And I just used a little liquid adhesive for that. Now I'm going to finish this off by adding some Tonic Aqua Shimmer Pin to the heart, as well as a layer of glossy accents, and that gives it a shiny, raised, glossy, glittery heart. And I love the way that this card turned out. But I have that other piece still, and I think we should make a card with that too. So the first card featured the spotlight stamping. This card is just featuring the amazingness of this stamp. And I'm gonna die cut it using one of the larger rectangles. I think this is the number 14. And I ran that through my die cut machine, and now I have this embossed black image. It's die cut beautifully. I really do like to die cut my rectangles because it gives it such a beautiful finished edge. And for this one, I'm gonna be mounting it onto a white card base. So this is a top folding A2 size card base made from some Essentials by Ellen linen cardstock. I have some craft cardstock that I'm die cutting using this adorable die from the Farmhouse Tags die set from the Essentials by Ellen line. It was a little long, so I went ahead and decided to die cut this again. I'm lining the bottom portion up within the die lines, but I'm gonna allow the top portion to kind of stick out. So I'm gonna make this a little bit shorter by die cutting it again and only die cutting the top portion. So once I run that through my die cut machine, you can see the portion I cut off there. And now I have that cute rounded top with the little holes on it, but it's shorter than the original die. So that's something you can definitely do, partial die cutting or die cutting it twice to make it a custom size is a great thing to do with your basic dies like this. Now I took a sentiment from the Mondo Holly stamp set. It says Merry Christmas, and I stamped it in Versamark ink onto this craft tag. I added some white embossing powder and I'm heat setting that. And do not forget to use your powder tool on craft cardstock because the extra kind of texture that it has will definitely grab extra embossing powder and you don't want to do that. So just trust me. Now I created a second tag from some red cardstock. I also made that one a little bit smaller by double die cutting it. And I die cut a rectangle from some Essentials by Ellen Vellum. And I'm gonna do some layering up in the corner of this card. I'm gonna keep it really simple, really classic, and allow that fa-la-la to really take center stage. But first of all, I need to stamp some greenery. And so I grabbed the brand new Holiday Sprigs stamp and die set from the Essentials by Ellen line. And I've inked up the outline portion with some Catherine Pooler Martini ink, which is a brand new color from the Catherine Pooler line. And then I stamped the solid portion using the Martini ink also. Now I'm going back and inking up just a portion of the solid stamp with the Deck the Halls ink from Catherine Pooler. And I softened the edge using a blending brush and stamped it right on top of the other image. And this gives the stamped image some really nice shading effects, and it's super simple to do. Now I'm grabbing some black and white baker's twine, and I'm gonna string these two little tags together. I love to layer tags. If you've never layered tags, you need to jump on board to the layered tags train with me because it's great. And I tied those in a bow at the top, and then I added my greenery behind. And I'm gonna add that little tag duo onto my vellum rectangle using some foam adhesive. And I added the vellum up to the upper right-hand corner of this card front using a little more foam adhesive. So there's a little dimension. And I stamped out some of the berries from the Holiday Sprigs stamp set, added those onto the greenery. And then I finished them off with a little bit of Tonic Aqua Shimmer Pin and some glossy accents. And that finishes off my second card for today. And I have to tell you, there's just something about this classic black and ivory and red color scheme that just really makes my heart go boom for the holidays. I'm actually sharing another card tomorrow on my YouTube channel, so be sure to come back. Featuring the same Fa-La-La stamp set, but it's gonna have a completely different look. So I love this classic Christmas look that we have going on today, but tomorrow you're gonna see a rainbow look that I think you're gonna love too. Now, as always, I will have links to the featured products used in these projects in the description at YouTube. So if you're looking for something in particular, be sure you check there. Or you can head on over to my blog at sprinkledwithglitter.com. I will have that linked in the description below. Over there, you'll find more still shots, more information, a complete list of supplies, some information on a fabulous sale that's happening over at ellenhudson.com, as well as some information on an Instagram hop that we are having to celebrate this fabulous release from the Essentials by Ellen line. So visit me over there. As always, thanks for stopping by. Thanks for watching. I am so glad you're here. If you enjoyed this video, I would love it if you would give it a thumbs up. And don't forget to subscribe and turn on the notifications here on my YouTube channel so you don't miss any of my papercraft and card making video tutorials. And if you love this video, I would love it if you would share it with a friend. Thanks again for watching, and until next time, I hope you have a fa-la-la-la fabulous day. Was that too much? That might have been too much. I think it was too much.